Es muy difícil
It's
hablar
really
del
difficult
caso
to talk about the Brazilian
20 minutos,
case in 20 minutes,
pero tengo que elegir
but I have to choose
cosas
some aspects
para decir a vosotros,
to
y
share
claro
with you, and of course,
que voy a elegir
I will choose
un recorte
just
desde la Comisión de
an
Amnistía,
outline
que
from the Amnesty Commission,
el lugar donde, el espacio donde
which
trabajo,
is the space where I work. And specifically, I would like to go deep into one key aspect to understand democratization processes, which is the issue of developing memory spaces from a perspective that these memory spaces and these mechanisms can establish intergenerational gatherings. That's a key point because, for example, my generation is the generation of democracy. I was born in 77. In 79, we had the first amnesty law, the self-amnesty.
Act.
For my generation, talking about dictatorship was a forbidden issue. Forbidden, but not forbidden because we could not speak. It was part of the past.
And
we are interested in the past. So it's really common. For people my generation not to know what happened in Brazil. So this is really common. It was really common when I step into my classrooms to teach, my students never heard anything about the Brazilian dictatorship. So from a perspective of a possible political and social transformation in Brazil, we are better, we have improved. But there is still a lot to do. But well, I cannot go into the Amnesty Commission strategies without talking about the Brazilian process. First, some of the people may ask themselves, well, who's this crazy girl who's part of an amnesty commission? But in Brazil, amnesty is a concept which is still in debate for civil society, for the relatives of the disappeared, political disappeared, and for some sectors who fight for democracy, amnesty has a semantic meaning which is really wide, wider. It's not just forgetting, it's the fight for freedom, the fight for reparation, for truth, memory, and justice. So when we took over the Amnesty Commission in 2007 during Lula's administration, we had a big task ahead, which was the redefinition of amnesty, the total change of Brazilian state policies on our transition issues. So very quickly, what was there before 2007? Before 2007, we did not have a dictatorship that was overthrown like the one in Argentina. We had some kind of dictatorship that had a transition that controlled its transition because militaries fought each other, they were divided, there was no way how to support to keep that dictatorship going. The militaries then started a very slow and gradual process of political openness and civil society in an organized way. The key sectors related to the relatives, years, the feminist movement was the first movement that started talking about amnesty, that started talking about amnesty not as forgiven but as the possibility of bringing people back to their homes, those political prisoners, to free them. So we started a fight for an amnesty law, which has never been a law of forget. The government, when we started fighting for this law, soon sent a draft to the Congress, which was the winning draft, which was the civil society draft, lost, was not passed for 5 votes. In our Congress, we had a lot of senators. They were appointed senators by the government. The bill that was passed was a bill by the government. It is not a general, irrestrictive amnesty for militaries, but just for activists. It was not a law like this. It was not a law that spoke openly about the amnesty of torturers, because they couldn't admit that there was torture in Brazil. It was a law that created an openness for our judicial power of the militaries, for them to have some kind of interpretation that the crimes committed by state agents were connected crimes. So they were connected to political crimes, they were forgiven. In 88, when we had our constitution, that contemplated an article on amnesty, but it was not the same amnesty. It was an amnesty that spoke about freedom and reparation. This amnesty of freedom and reparation gave birth 14 years later, in 2001 or 2002, to the law that created the Amnesty Commission, of which I'm a part. So this is a reparation commission that was passed by a minority at Congress, because from 88 to 2001, 2008 to be specific, we were able to do away with the narration of events, which was the narration of forget. We had the time of forget in Brazil. That was an important time for militaries in Brazil, because that consolidated a generation who had forgotten about the dictatorship crimes. When we took over in 2001, when we started working in the Amnesty Commission, as Victor said in the previous panel, that was a strategy of the militaries: pay, compensate, so that people stayed quiet. It was like a muzzle. That was the way it was seen. But when the Amnesty Commission, when we started working there, we got a task, an important task, which was the redefinition of the concept of amnesty. So we introduced many changes, procedural rights changes. We started apologizing in the name of the Brazilian state. We apologize to victims. It's not that the state forgive victims, etymologically speaking, the way amnesty might state. On the contrary, the Brazilian state apologizes to the victims for all the crimes and violations that took place. And this is really moving. I know that Gaston has seen this because very often people do not want the money. People want to listen that the state really regrets what has happened, even if it's not the same state in terms of representation. One of the issues was this. Another aspect we worked on as well was try to recognize the importance of the resistance, the groups that resisted dictatorship. People should not be ashamed because they won, they got a reparation from the state. Nope. We should be thankful because they resisted, because they are responsible for the democracy we have today. And that was a strategy, an important one, because many people said that they were afraid of publicly saying that they got amnesty. And that was very expensive for us. How can we give amnesty, repair, and later on people do not say this was so because they feel ashamed? We developed three important projects. We have other projects, but I'm going to specifically concentrate on these three. The first, which is the project of the amnesty caravans. So far, we have had 86 caravans in Brazil. We decided to leave the Ministry of Justice, which in general is too far, and we started doing having our sessions in the different cities in Brazil. So, with the support of some organizations of civil society, such as trade unions, universities, different agencies, we started organizing events that dealt with transitional justice and also hold our meetings in public so that those who were politically followed to be able to listen to them. In Brasilia is in the city of the country, but it's far away from the rest.
Perseguidos políticos del sur, de donde vengo. Es muy costoso, es muy caro.
Those followed by political reasons, it's very it's very costly to go to an amnesty commission. So we started doing the reverse procedure to take the commission close to people. The effect is very important. In fact, we have a space of intergenerational meeting. There's no price for this. Young people realize that, realize what torture is, because in all procedures, victims narrate the facts. And of course, this is a moment of admiration for those who,
sendo indenizadas por el Estado brasileiro,
compensated and repaired by the state. This is a big project in our commission, one of the main projects, because We can have these intergenerational meetings. And in Brazil, soon, we started to get claims from students to know more about this, for us to produce material. So this commission, created by many advisors from academia, we started having a theory production on the issue in Brazil. And the second project called Marks on Memory, which are public calls to invest in cultural projects of civil society. For example, there is a theater group that has a play about the Brazilian dictatorship. They can go to all Brazil with their play, and schools also. There are many projects.
Con teatro y escuelas para escuelas primarias, escuelas para niños y para
primary schools, secondary schools. There are specific theater languages to explain kids what dictatorship was, and also same applies to teens. Many associations of political persecuted, projects with schools, debate cycles. This testimony of somebody who has been persecuted, we have invested. There are music groups, for example, that give concerts, songs that were censored during dictatorship times. There are many beautiful projects. The most interesting in connection with being in connection with memory is the financing of films. We have today 20 films that were financed by the Amnesty Commission. Many of those got prizes, international prizes. They are documentaries in general regarding the Brazilian dictatorship. Interesting documentaries. Some, for example, develop the issue of militants who said, no, we are not going to be part of this, who have been forgotten in politics today, but who resisted from within. There are documentaries, beautiful ones, who are totally free. We do not charge anything to see the films. It's always free. When, for example, the university or civil society organizations wishes to have a debate cycle, we give them the boxes with all the films for them to move around the country, organizing these cycles, these debates. There is even a box that is for CIEP. That year specifically was the 50th anniversary of the coup d'etat. So we made a big effort to hold debate cycles and above all to, for films to reach the young with debates, because they become involved with the visual language of films. The last project are called Testimonies Clinics, the last dimension, reparatory dimension that we could increase. First it was just an economic reparation, then was moral, with the apology, and finally now we have a reparation.
psicológica.
Which is psychological.
Então, são clínicas que they are clinics
that we hire to have a maintenance
perseguidos políticos,
for
pero que
politically persecuted people,
but
has
importante.
Something in particular which to me is important. These are clinics that deal with politically persecuted from dictatorships, but also who
listas a atender
deal with the people who suffer from violations on the part of the Brazilian government as well today, and this is a paradox.
So we have created a space.
Very often these vocal focus groups mix political persecuted people from dictatorship with groups of outcasts,
que também são
young people, criminalized groups
por las clínicas. E é trabalho muito, muito bonito.
Deal with them and
é muito importante.
Do a very good job.
Então, claro que todo esse trabalho da comissão de
amnistia, work of the Amnesty Commission together with a series of
de questões conjunturales que foram ocorrendo na nossa história, como por exemplo,
issues in different sectors such as the condemnation of the Inter-American Court and Human Rights,
deu incluso origem à nossa Comissão Nacional de la Verdad, porque a Comissão Nacional de la Verdad só existe hoje em Brasil, porque é parte do cumprimento da sentença da corte.
Part of the sentence of the court.
E é uma comissão que sim que claro, tiene dificultades, pero nosotros teníamos una comisión de la verdad.
We had a commission on truth. This is very important.
Entonces, yo hago un análisis de que
I do my own analysis.
Hoy en Brasil, nosotros
today in Brazil, we have like a third stage
de la transición
of the political transition.
Que es una fase
it's a stage
justicia y verdad.
Of justice and truth.
Y los síntomas de esa fase
and the
para
symptoms
mí son tres.
Are three.
El primero
first,
es que nosotros tenemos hoy movimientos sociales
social
de jóvenes como es el ejemplo el Levante Popular de la Juventud,
like
que hace
Levante Popular de la Juventud.
This is the name of the movement in Spanish
that criticizes openly the torturers.
Que hace un trabajo muy importante porque es muy emocionante
job.
Ver jóvenes
it's really moving to see
que,
the young
que no necesitaban estar ahí.
Do not need to be there like me. In my generation, the way my generation was not there.
Exigiendo sus derechos a la verdad
demanding, defending their right to truth and justice. This is the first symptom. The second symptom is the symptom of the organization of civil society for the production of truth.
Así que la nuestra presidenta.
Our president.
Aprobou a lei de amnistia.
Passed the Amnesty Act.
Desculpe-me. A lei da criação da Comissão da Verdade. Imediatamente,
on the creation of the Commission on Truth, and many provinces in Brazil immediately started to create their own commissions on truth,
which
happened in Argentina in a similar way, but I think that in CONADEP.
In Brazil, no, son totalmente independientes.
To CONADEP in Brazil, they are totally independent. Public universities in Brazil started having commissions on truth to fight for the rights regarding issues, university issues. They are very active. Some are even more active than the Commission on Truth.
Al final, claro,
end,
creo
of
que
course,
todos los materiales que fueron
produced,
no producidos, pero
well, not exactly produced,
que fueron angariados por las comisiones, que fueron all recuperados por las comisiones, van a ser todos dados a la Comisión de la Verdad, ser entregues a la Comisión Nacional de la Verdad. Y creo que va a ayudar muchísimo el trabajo de la Comisión de la Verdad. Así que,
on truth.
Que tengo a decir para encerrar porque
so to round off,
terminó,
because I'm running out of time,
tenemos una sociedad hoy que es una sociedad
today.
Mejor.
It's a better society.
No hay duda que es una
no
sociedad mejor.
This society
los medios
is better.
De comunicación
means of communication apologize publicly
for
having supported our dictatorship.
We were in
a situation in which militaries cannot deny that we had torture in our country any longer, that we have political disappearances. Of course, we have progressed a lot. But there is a lot to do. And this a lot to do
está vinculado
has to
al hecho de que el Estado brasileiro
with the fact that the Brazilian state continues violating rights.
Os niveles de violência institucional em
institutional violence in Brazil are really
pero
high.
But violence today is a violence
with
de la favela.
The black youth of the favela, the slums. And now we debate violence, police violence, when last year
police
was really violent in trying to control protests, demonstrations in Brazil. And there we have a little bit of all types of people. So the middle class discovered last year that police is violent in Brazil, that kills.
Que hace con que las personas desaparezcan,
that
sí.
Make people disappear.
Entonces, yo creo que so, y también nosotros tenemos que enfrentar la otra cuestión, que
issue,
es el hecho de que vivimos en un
the
país con muchas desigualdades sociales.
A lot of social inequalities.
Hay una parcela entera de nuestra población
so
que no puede acceder a la memoria.
Access to memory,
no puede acceder ninguna
does
memoria
not have access
porque
to any kind
hambre.
Of memory because they are hungry.
Y porque en cuanto tienen hambre
because
no van a acceder a nada.
You cannot have access to nothing.
Y no puedo hablar de
and I cannot talk about going deeper into a democracy where
hambre.
People are hungry.
Entonces,
so we need to invest
en reformas institucionales
in institutional reforms.
Que nosotros tenemos muy pocas. Nosotros
we
tenemos
very few
hasta hoy una
ones.
Justicia militar
so
que juzga los
even
militares
today we have a military
crimes,
justice that
mejor, no
judges
juzga.
Militars for their crimes, or rather, does not judge
y
them.
Entonces, quiero decir que tenemos que luchar por una sociedad,
we have to fight
sí,
for a society,
más democrática,
a more
y en términos de democracia substancial,
yo no democracy.
Tengo una ilusión de que debemos luchar por una democracia plena, una democracia de esas en que decimos así, bien, ahora sí,
where we say, good, now,
me puedo
yes,
salir de vacaciones porque tenemos una democracia plena.
No,
las democracias no
democracy
tienen fines en sí propias.
Does not have a name in itself. They are processes
siempre tenemos
where
que estar
we have to be
porque avanzamos
attentive.
Y
we
retrocedemos.
Have to
y el ejemplo de Honduras y de Paraguay,
the example
que
of Honduras,
no
Paraguay,
de tanques de
they
guerra
didn't need
para hacer sus
tanks.
Golpes.
For their coup,
están ahí
their
para
tats.
Demostrar
they are
cuánto
there
tenemos
to
que
show
ser
how
vigilantes.
Much we have to control.
Luchar por esta
how much we have to survey
es luchar
for this democracy.
Para que
we have to fight for above all, for all and
pueda
every single citizen to become a controller of democracy so that in the face of
humanos,
a violation on human rights,
hoy,
whichever the kind of the past
decir,
of the present,
no,
to say no, no more, I don't want to live in a place like this any longer.
Por eso que
that's why
estos encuentros intergeneracionales son muy importantes
meetings
porque
are really important because it's the bridge between the past and the
el
present.
No
the past cannot be isolated from things that take place today
países.
In our
las
countries. The things that take place
hoy
are better understood when we understand our past and we have the exercise, the memory exercise to
lugar de
stand
las
in the shoes of the victims.
Yo soy una persona con esperança.
I'm hopeful. I'm hopeful, and of course I'm really proud of having the opportunity to be part of the Amnesty Commission and fight for democracy in my country.
But we need to be careful. Al no olvidar el pasado,
not to forget the past,
and not just look
at the past all the time. We have to pay attention to violations today and debate, of course, always how to go deeper into our institutions so that our youth or any person has the conditions, as I said before, to fight for that democracy and learn to say no. Thank you.